Hey, what's up Blender users, I am Jonathan, and in today's video, we're going to create some abstract art in Blender 2.81, like the ones you can see right now. And by the way, if you enjoy my content, you might want to consider subscribing, because I upload a new video every Saturday. And with that said and done, let's get straight into the video. As you can see, these abstract shapes are based on a cloth simulation, so we're gonna start with that. So, open up a new file, and I'm just gonna delete everything. Then add in a UV sphere as our collider and also a plane. I'm gonna scale this plane up by 2 and move it upwards. Now add a subdivision surface modifier, keep it simple, and also set the divisions to 6. Now we can go over to the physics tab and enable cloth and select our sphere and enable collision. Now we can just run the simulation and find a frame we like. Okay, so I'm really liking this frame right here, so I'm just gonna select my cloth and apply all the modifiers, and we now have this object. I can also now delete the sphere and go over to object, set origin and origin to geometry, so we have the origin right in the middle right here. Okay, now we're gonna start with all the modifiers. I really want to kind of destroy this mesh, so I'm gonna use a mix between a decimate modifier as well as a displace modifier. And on top of that, I will duplicate this mesh and add some wireframe. To decide where to put the decimate modifier, I'm going to use a procedural vertex group with a noise texture. So let's start with that. We can already add in 2 empties to control the noise and go over to the texture tab, press new and select distorted noise as well as select cell noise. We can also adjust the size to, for example, 0.5. Now go over to the modifiers tab and add in vertex weight edit. With that, we can edit vertex groups and add or remove vertices based on a texture. So of course we will need 2 vertex groups, so I'm just gonna add in 2 and name them accordingly. So the one is called decimate and the second one displace, like that. Now for our first vertex group, I'm gonna start with decimate, group add and group remove, and choose custom curve, and to make it work we will have to use a curve which is flipped. And now we can select our texture and also use our empty for our texture coordinates. So now to preview this, we can add the decimate modifier and put the ratio to something to 0.1, and now we will use the decimate vertex group, and we can now see that where our texture is, it will be decimated like this. And if we move our empty, we will also move the texture. But I really like the placing of the texture right now, so I'm just gonna leave it. Now add in another vertex weight edit modifier and select our displace vertex group. Also again, check group add and remove and edit our curve. I will just use the same texture, but the other empty. And now add in a displace modifier, which in the first glance looks really off, but we can just select our displace vertex group, adjust the strength to, for example, 0.15, and we can, for example, also use the same texture to make it more interesting. If we now move the empty around, we can see we will also move our displace modifier around, and we can find a spot that we like. And I'm just gonna go with that. You can also scale the empty to displace less of the mesh, or scale it down to displace more. So I'm just gonna scale it up a bit to get like some waves on the mesh. So to smooth everything out, we will just need a subdivision surface modifier, which I'm just gonna set to 2, and we will also set the whole mesh to smooth. To make it a bit more smoother, we can also use the smooth modifier and set the factor to 1. Sometimes I get some interesting results by setting the factor to 5, but not in this case. You can also, of course, control the smooth modifier with a vertex group with the same technique as above, but I'm not gonna do this for this mesh. To now make the wireframe, I'm just gonna duplicate this mesh and add a wireframe modifier on top. You will now see that this happens, which is exactly not what we want, because we want the wireframe to be a lot thinner. But I'm not going to do this with the thickness, but the relative thickness. So uncheck even thickness and check relative thickness. And we can now see that we get this wireframe, which is exactly what I want. And now we can start with the shading and lighting process. So for the scene, I'm just going to add in a plane to be our ground, and the camera will be on top. So press 7 on your number pad and move the camera to where you want it to be, like this. I'm also going to set the world to black, and we can now go into rendered view, add in some lights, and I'm just going to use 3 lights, 3 area lights, like this, duplicate them to the sides to make some interesting lighting, for example like this. If you want to render this in Eevee, I would suggest you going into the shadow tab and enabling soft shadows, but later I will use cycles to render the scene. I will also use some grunge maps, like this one, to make the shading process a bit easier. So select our mesh, and this time not the wireframe mesh, go into the shader editor and give it a new material. So now in rendered view, I'm gonna get the grunge map from before and plug it into the color and roughness input. And you can see, because we used a plane, this is already unwrapped, but these are not the colors I want. So I'm just gonna use a color ramp and make the brighter color a lot darker, like this. And we can now see that we get some interesting shading. We can also duplicate this color ramp, not flip, but reset it, and now adjust it to get the right roughness amount we want. And we can also play around with the metallic look. What I also like to do is just get a bump node, plug in the grunge map as the height, and plug it into the normal to get some interesting bumps. But of course, the strength is way too high, so I'm just going to lower it to something around there. And with the wireframe, I want a mix between a principled BSDF and an emission shader. So I'm just going to use a noise texture for this, and we can preview it by holding down Ctrl, Shift, and click on the node if you have the node wrangler add-on enabled. And now duplicate this noise, plug the factor of the second noise into the vector of the first noise, and we can also add a color ramp. This is just to get a more interesting noise. And if we now adjust the color ramp, we can see that we can isolate some spots on our wireframe mesh. And this isolation we will now use as a factor for our mix shader. So mix the principled BSDF with an emission shader. And I'm also gonna really make the principled BSDF a lot darker and turn up the metallic. Maybe not completely to 1, like this. And now we can also plug in the emission shader and preview our shading. Okay, of course, our emission shader has to be way stronger, so I'm gonna set it to 30. And we can also adjust the spots where we want it to be, just like this. We can, of course, add in a second mix shader and also a second emission shader. And the great thing about 2.81 is that we can now, if we duplicate our noises, we can now change them to 4D and adjust the W value just to get another seed. And now plug this in, and we can now see that we got some more lighting, and we can also change the colors to, for example, orange and blue. I think that these work pretty well together. And we now got the basic shading. I also, of course, want to make the plane a lot darker, like this, and also turn down the specular and turn up the roughness to get a nice even ground. Okay, now we can go over to cycles, GPU for me, and preview our scene. And yes, this is essentially it. This is how to make these abstract geometries, this abstract art. And if you really want some nice detail, you can also enable depth of field, but this is all up to you. And if you find this tutorial helpful, you might want to consider liking and subscribing, and we're gonna see us in the next video.